down with you. Then you got real town in there, all kind of the same thing. I'm from the other direction. I'm from Montgomery. Agnes, he's got a question about some
girl.
The United States Congress never disestablished the reservations of the five tribes.
Americans, the Muscogee Creek and the Seminole Nation, and one of their great patriots and warriors, Osceola. Behind me is the great Tallapoosa River. About 3 miles south on the east bank was the Muscogee village of Taliesin, where Osceola was born. A short distance past Taliesin, on the right bank, was the great Muscogee town of Tuckabatchee, the capital of the Upper Creek Indians. Taliesin was settled in 1835, the present town of Taliesin, 183 years ago, but was not incorporated until January the 21st, 1908. So as an incorporated city, we are 110 years old. Because the mill owned most of the property in Taliesin, this is the East Taliesin Mill Village. And then there was a West Taliesin Mill Village with the two, there were over 800 houses owned by the mill and the two mill villages. The town was not incorporated until after, well, Jordanville was incorporated as the town of Taliesin. And then the other, the mill villages came in the 50s after the
Taliesin. I was born in Lee County Hospital. My parents lived here in Taliesin. So I was reared here in Taliesin. I went to the elementary school right here where now I work at City Hall. And so I'm very excited about this monument going up. I read History of Taliesin book years ago, and I would always tell people, you know, the great history of Taliesin, especially when I went off to college at the University of Alabama, you know, people, you're from Tallahassee, Florida. No, I'm from Taliesin, Alabama. You know, there's not an H in there. But I was like, but Tallahassee is actually, you know, named from Taliesin. And I tell them this, and I tell them facts, and they'd look at me like I'm crazy. Like, I thought you lived in a little small 4,000 person town. I was like, that's right. But we have a lot of history. We might be a small town, but we're rich in tradition and history here in Taliesin. And it warms my heart to see everyone that has showed up today. I know the Historical Society has done a lot of planning for this unveiling. They came to me and they wanted to put it at City Hall. We let one monument, we can't say no to anybody else, so I do apologize that it's not over there, but I think this is fitting. It's right here at the superintendent's house where the Historical Society meets every month, and I'm looking forward to seeing it today. I welcome all of you to our great city of Taliesin. If you ever need anything, just let me know. Thank you.
Ann Christian is one of the founders, chartered members of the Taliesin Historical Preservation Society, which was formed in October of 1995. She has also served us with honor as our 2nd, 11th, and 12th presidents. She is now serving as our 13th president. Excuse me, number 13. It is now my honor to present Ann Christian.
Thank you, Bill. I didn't realize I was number 13, and I'm not the least bit suspicious, but I hurry up. If you would, please, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come thanking you for our many blessings, including the safe travels of our guests and of their return home. We gather to honor one of our local natives. We thank you for all lives that existed and battled through the years for their rights. We thank you for the representatives of the different nations of our American Native brothers and sisters, most all originating in this locale, for their desire to come and be part of this ceremony. Things of so good. I ask this in your holy name. Well, as Bill said, I am president. I have been a chartered member, and there's about 3 or 4 chartered members here today. And on behalf of the members of THPS and Friends of Tuckabatchee, we welcome you all. And at this time, I'd like to recognize the members of THPS. If you would stand, please. Every member, or if you are standing, wave so people can see you. Now I would like the Friends of Tuckabatchee to stand, and you will see we are honored that the Opelika DAR chapter selected THPS as a partner in recognition of Osceola. Osceola has always been my first American Native, that is Geronimo. Geronimo, I believe I'm right, was imprisoned at Fort Pickens, Florida, and I'm from that area. And then I had to do a report in the 8th grade on someone famous in Florida, so I chose Osceola. And what I wrote is nothing like what it is, I can promise you. But I got it out of the encyclopedia. As I said, we are grateful to DAR, and THPS is always open for ideas that will honor our ancestors, and such an event.
In January of 2017, I got a call from Agnes Golden Tatum, a Tallahassee native, a member of the Opelika DAR, and some people have said, what does that mean? It's the Daughters of the American Revolution. To become a member, you have to have an ancestor who fought in the American Revolution. My 5th great-grandfather, James Goss, did in Jamestown, Virginia, and I have not joined the Sons of the American Revolution, but I would be eligible to do so. Agnes told me that the members of the Opelika DAR would like to honor Osceola and that they needed a project for 2017-2018 and asked if the Taos Historical Preservation Society would help them. And I took that request to the next meeting of the society and we agreed that we would. And if you look on the front of the program at the bottom, you will see their official name. It's named the Martha Wells Jefferson DAR Chapter of Opelika. And at this point, I want to introduce the person that I've been working with from Opelika, Linda Chabot. She is the chairperson of the Martha Wells Jefferson DAR Bicentennial Committee. Their project is a part of their bicentennial year, and she will explain that further. So it's my honor to present Linda.
Thank you,
extremely honored to be here. And I would like not only to thank everyone here, but I also want to recognize the members of the DAR who've come from their various places, some of them surprising me, and I'm just very honored because we are trying as a group to recover and celebrate the best part of Alabama's history as we go toward our 200-year bicentennial. I'm supposed to introduce people in this orderly fashion from DAR, but I'm going to start out of order by asking Agnes Tatum to please stand up. Please, Agnes, I want to recognize you as Bill Gorsaker. Agnes is my co-chairman, and quite truthfully, I think she has done more than I could possibly do, because I think you know that she is a native of this community and loves it. In fact, she went to high school here. That saying, I'm not going to say a lot about Osceola or even what we're trying to do as a bicentennial, because you're going to have somebody in a minute named Connie Grun, if you look at your program, who is our bicentennial commission chairman. And I think she knows a little bit more about what she's trying to do and we're trying to do. And she's traveled very much with it through the state trying to get our bicentennial organized. So I'll leave that to her. But I would like, if we could, and I'm going to try to introduce some of them, would every DAR member who has come here today please do me the, I'll let you off the hook, and do me the honor of standing up a minute. I'm going to try to introduce some of you. If I get out of order, they may forgive me. I'm going to start over here. This young lady is Tammy Clemens. She is our new regent-elect, representing all of us in Alabama very shortly, a very hard job. We also have here our first regent for the state of Alabama, Patrice Donnelly, who's come to you from Birmingham. These people drive. That's why I'm very glad at my advanced age I don't have to do much of that. Connie will speak to you in a minute. She's Connie Grun. And this is the regent here. This is Mary Rudd, who is the regent, like the president, of our Martha Wells Jefferson DAR chapter. And she supported us very much with the money. And because there for a while, we didn't know what we were undertaking. It's a beautiful, as you will see, plaque. And so much has been done down here. This young lady over here is heroic. She's gotten out of a car accident. Her name is Kathy Petten. She is a former regent of our Martha Wells Jefferson chapter. The car did not survive, but she's here. And she's also a board member of the Opelika Historic Museum, which is comparable to maybe what you're doing down here. Now, I have other men. Tell me who you are. Becky, you're standing the front. She's our chapter, so she doesn't have to say anything. But everybody else has to yell who they are.
I'm Athelia Gibbs. I'm the state treasurer for Alabama Society Daughters of the American Revolution.
And I'm Elizabeth Spear Gillen from Wetumpka, and I am also the state corresponding secretary.
And I'm Rita Reed from Shelby County, and I'm the state recording secretary.
I'm Nancy Hayden from Auburn, and I'm a member of the Martha Wells Jefferson chapter of the DA.
The state of Alabama has chosen to celebrate the bicentennial for 3 years. So they are celebrating from the anniversary of when we became the Alabama Territory in 1817 until statehood in 1819. Now, over the 3 years, our 70 chapters across the state have each been choosing a bicentennial project to help learn about the early history of Alabama, in turn teach about the early history, and also to preserve the early history. So this is an absolutely perfect project. We also have been encouraged by the state to join with the local governments, historical societies, businesses in town, and all of our local community, and work together on these projects. And so this wonderful collaboration between the Tallahassee Historical Preservation Society and the Martha Wales Jefferson DAR chapter is a perfect example of how to do this. It is a great honor to be honoring and recognizing Osceola today. He was a leader of his people and cared greatly about his people, and was born here in Alabama and is one of our most famous Alabamians. So thank you very much to all of you that have worked so hard to make this possible.
Week, Charles Chambers told me that he had contacted the assistant chief of the Seminole Nation of Oklahoma, and that he would be able to come here if he had an official invitation. So I immediately sent him an email on Monday morning and invited him to come and join us today. You see his name on the program, you see his title. Let me tell you a few things about him. He is a part of the Bird clan and the Tallahassee clan. He has decades of tribal experience and service to the citizens of the Seminole Nation of Oklahoma. He has served four different principal chiefs. He's the assistant. He has served four other chiefs in the Seminole Nation, so it is a great honor that I'm able to present to you Lewis Johnson, Assistant Chief of the Seminole Nation of Oklahoma.
Thank you, Mr. Goss, and thank each and every one of you who are here today to commemorate this very special day and unveiling of the monument. First of all, I want to say thank you for all the ladies, the historical societies, different organizations like the Daughters of the American Revolution. It takes all these functions of these organizations to continue to keep the history alive in our different areas of where we live. And let's just give them a hand clap of appreciation for their work through the years. And very close to my heart is these types of historical societies and these organizations, because I spent about 25 years in the museum field, both working in fellowships with the Smithsonian Institute at the Washington level, along with my dear friend Ted Isom, who was my GPS coming down here to the Tallahassee. I actually didn't need the GPS, did I, Ted? I've been down here many times to Wetumpka and other places in this area. But Ted, colonial grounds there back home in Oklahoma. And he's also been in the museum field and served several fellowships together with the Smithsonian side by side, creating certain exhibits. So it's good to have him to come down with us as well from Oklahoma. What I want to do is to express that it indeed is an honor, and I am humbled on behalf of the Seminole Nation of Oklahoma to be here with each and every one of you here today. It has always been an outpouring of great hospitality and great kindness from the people here in Alabama and the whole South whenever we come back to visit our homelands as well. So it's always good to be here. Ted and I, as we was driving down, we always have a certain feeling that swells up with inside of us when we walk around these areas and around the rivers and some of the sites that we often get to see from time to time. But we know what it is. We know it is the spirit of our ancestors and how they still speak to us in a spiritual way to us when we come back to a place such as Tallahassee, Alabama. As Mr. Goss had said, I am of the Bird Clan, and I am also of Tallahassee Tribal Band. We still have a traditional form of government among the Oklahoma Seminoles. We are the last tribe in the state of Oklahoma to still have a traditional form of government, which means we have the tribal council is made up of all these original tribal towns and tribal bands. And though many times people will say we ought to get away from is a representative and a derivative of the folks who lived in this area. And it has been told since I was a child that Osceola actually, you know, had close relations or came directly from our particular band. And we have an Osceola Tallahassee Days actually back in Oklahoma, usually the month of October. But indeed, when you think about Osceola, you think about many people talk about as he grew up and obviously was thrown into the conflicts of that day and that time period and era of our history. But you know, as I woke up this morning, I looked out the window, seen the sun coming up. My hotel room was facing undeveloped area. There was woods back there, and it was beautiful as I seen it. And I think about this young boy as he was born in the vicinity of this area. As he was born in this vicinity of this area, this is what began to formulate and to begin to make him what he would become one day whenever conflict or whenever there were things that came against him and his people to stand for what he believed in. You know, I was at the Seminole Nation Days many, many years ago, and Leon Bale, many of y'all know Leon, and Leon was talking, and he said, I want you to know that what you see here today, and he was talking about the dance that was fixing to take place. He said, I want you to know that today this still continues because somebody believed that it could continue, and it cost some of us, our ancestors, their blood to continue this way of life and this way of practicing of our traditional ways of life. So when I think about a young boy who grew up here, he was not that warrior that we sometimes hear romanticized from time to time in American history, but he was a little boy, much like your own children, much like your own grandchildren, much like my own children and my grandchildren. They're learning from their uncles, their clan affiliates, their clan leaders. They're learning the things they